The State Water Project has a number of pumping and generating plants around the state. And here at Thermalito, we've recently improved the efficiency of this generation plant, which is going to lead to a reduction in the carbon footprint of our department.
The Thermalito Power Plant is part of the Oroville Thermalito complex, and it provides water storage, flood control, water delivery, and also power generation for the entire state of California. So we're standing on the top deck of Thermalito Power Plant right now. To my right is Unit 4, and at the far end is Unit 1. All of the units are turbine units, which convert potential energy from water and turns it into rotational energy, which is then used to generate electricity. Unit 1 is the one we're most excited about. That's a Kaplan unit, and that unit was reaching the end of its service life. What we saw there was an opportunity to greatly increase the efficiency by replacing the turbine. We're able to increase efficiency from 86% to 93% during that process using cap and trade funds.
So the department's carbon footprint is largely all of the pumping that the State Water Project does to provide water to 27 million Californians. We actually generate at facilities like here at Thermalito over half the energy needs of the project. The department has a comprehensive climate action plan. It's actually made up of three phases that covers everything from reducing our carbon footprint to getting ready for the climate impacts that are coming our way. Phase one of the climate action plan focuses solely on reducing our carbon footprint, so it includes about a dozen measures to do so. Clean hydroelectricity, like that produced here at Thermalito, is a key part of the state's overall carbon reduction plan.
Thermalito Unit 1 is a part of a portfolio of projects aimed at increasing the efficiency of our generating facilities. As we get more efficiency out of our generating facilities, we're able to produce more clean energy. We are also doing refurbishments on our pumping facilities, which will allow us to consume less energy as those efficiencies are increased. This reduces our need to purchase power from non-clean energy sources and moves us closer to our goal of having the State Water Project be 100% emissions free by 2045.
The department has actually reduced its carbon footprint by over 70% compared to our 1990 levels already. And to put that into some context, state law requires that the state actually be 40% below its 1990 levels by 2030. So you can see that the department is already well ahead of what the state mandates are. Climate change is already having a lot of impacts on California, and at the department, we're trying to do our part to reduce those impacts. Things like this energy efficiency project here at Thermalito, and in increasing that efficiency of this turbine, we're contributing to California's clean energy future.